So we were in the wrong key. Oh, I love the wigs in this episode!
The director, upon seeing us, all the lads in the wigs, walked in, didn't say anything, laughed, and said, "Why have we got the Beatles in?"
Yeah, it was such a great decision for this episode. Everyone was like, it could be set at any time, but it would be good if like mobile phones and stuff aren't available because you're cutting the phone wire. Mm. But then it can't be like super old fashioned. We've got some period pieces. Oh, she's back. And so, yeah, sort of like 60s, isn't it? Which I love.
One tiny note. When we did our dress rehearsal, the play ran very smoothly, but just a touch too short for its time slot. But do not fear. We have managed to make up those missing 3 minutes with the subtle use of additional adjectives.
There is a truth gag in this episode.
Oh, truth gag!
Yeah.
Yes, so the additional adjectives is kind of a joke based in total truth, in that we ran the episode as it was before we filmed it, about 4 days before, 5 days before, and we were 2 minutes short. So we added the adjective joke to pad out the episode for real.
And they were given to us that day. So you can see me later on completely forget what it was.
But then ironically, when we filmed it, the episode overran by 4 minutes. So we had to cut other material, which was just, you know, a bit of a pain in the arse, really.
Period fixtures and fittings throughout. Almost everything here is an antique, so please, do be careful.
Small thing. The vase was made of wax so that it could break. So, in order to catch it, I had to catch it gently without it shattering in my hands.
I think you did really well. I'm very impressed with this physical comedy business sequence.
And I've still got the turtleneck upstairs.
Yeah, I think it really suits you.
In fact, I might go and put it on. TV magic!
Should we take a look in the kitchen?
We're going to talk about the kitchen.
Yeah, we had to ADR the word kitchen.
Because of that, you did it again.
Because I say kitchen. And director Martin was just like, he was like, yeah, we're going to ADR this because, well, there's no sound issue. It's just you're saying it weird.
Kitchen.
You're saying kitchen.
Kitchen.
And we figured out the more I said kitchen normally, because we'd recorded me doing this, it made no sense from if I just said kitchen. It looked weird, so they had to put in kitchen. Weird.
But it is less bad than
yeah.
the one you did.
Also, because I went up at the end, I went, should we take a look in the kitchen? And it was very weird. Weird choice on the night.
Where did you find that?
Well, she must have found it in the spacious, impressive, verdant green garden surrounding the unusual, creepy old, big, large blue house.
Alice, how old are you?
7.
Oh, look, Nancy in her incredible costume. She looks so good in this episode.
Nance was petrifying in this.
Nance was petrifying. Brian, he was incredible. You were all right.
That's strange. It's gone.
This is a really good episode for Chris Leask.
Mm.
I think he does very good trying to take the doll acting.
He goes... No arse there for Chris in this one.
No bottom.
Oh, also, when Nance fell out of the door, there wasn't enough space for us to both fall in the same crash mat.
Come on, Alice! I'll race you!
So she had to hit and roll. And the way that I knew, because I'd never looked, I just fell. And the way that I knew Nance hit the thing, and when she was clear, she'd go, make that noise. And then I would know that it was clear to fall. So she literally goes bang, rolls out the way, and then I fall.
Yeah, and I was also back there at that point for a lot of this. So I would just hear all this like kerfuffle with like bang, roll, bang, roll. It's just bizarre. I'd be like, is everyone okay?
Good evening. Sorry, didn't mean to scare you.
Oh, not at all.
I'm Albert Fortnoy.
The vendor.
Yeah, unfortunately, yes.
Unfortunately?
I wish I didn't have to sell. My dear wife Vera passed away 30 years ago. 30 years ago today, in fact. I can no longer afford the upkeep all on my own.
I think the build of the stairlift is quite good.
Mm.
Because it could be so tempting to do just a big trick immediately. But the fact that it's just little by little, a couple of things go wrong, it's a bit quick, and then later we lead to the big sort of denouement of the stairlift.
So the stairs are operated by just two lads.
I've lived here all my life! I feel very safe here.
And just a massive counterweights and just two guys pulling Hannah up and down the stairs.
Because actually using an electronic thing doesn't quite work, like usually takes time to kind of build up speed, you can't be precise, whereas people are strangely more precise.
But this is all done in one take, and the thing was meant to go out the window. But if you notice, it hits the glass and then bounces into the frame and comes back out. And I've never done that before. Also, what are those things called? The little soda stream things.
Mm.
There was two of them. So there was the one that I pick up. And the reason I fall out of shot is because there's another one preset on the floor with water in it.
So there's one you knock over and then you pick up one with water in.
So I fall out of shot, immediately switch them out and come back up with the one... the correct one to spray myself in the face. That was really tough because I had to fall over in exactly the right spot, and I also had to roll away the other one so that when they cut round to the wide, it wasn't in the shot.
Good at that, aren't you?
I don't think I did it very well, but I did it well enough for them to use it, so.
Also, this episode includes Jonathan Sayers'
the famous
epic
Get Out.
Get Out.
Yeah.
You'll never get a mechanic to come all the way out here now, dear.
Get out! Get out!
No, no, not now.
She said now, dear. She said now, dear, is probably my favourite just kind of one-liner in the whole series. In fact, this is probably playing the deer is my favourite part I had. Although, doing this... for 3 hours, which is what I had to do essentially on the night, is without doubt the most painful thing I've ever had to do in any of the shows. In fact, I've still got like really a really, really sore neck. So I challenge you at home. In fact, no, I don't challenge you because you'll hurt yourself. See how long you can do this for. I'm also really pleased by how much people have enjoyed Get Out! I've had loads of weird requests to do different things in the current situation. People have asked me to do one saying, stay in! People have asked for an alarm clock with, wake up! So, you know, tweet in your requests and, you know, hopefully I'll do that.
Fortnoy Lodge has a few little quirks, which I'm sure you'll discover. But then again, don't we all? Sleep well.
And so begins the laughing section.
We'll see you in 10. The laughing section is so effective. It's amazing that it's just a man screaming.
I remember in rehearsal, Henry would go, guys, is it too much? Is it too much? And we'd be like, I think in order to work, it needs to be too much. It needs to go beyond what the audience is expecting.
It needs to be more, if anything.
More. I think we could get away with more. And there's also something so infectious.
Mm.
It's scientific, isn't it? The science says if you hear someone laughing after a while, you just start laughing yourself.
Chuck a blanket over him.
Oh, for goodness sake, all right.
Strategically placed whiskey bottle.
There was that an accident?
It was in rehearsal. And then we kept it in for the actual show. I think we told the BBC it was an accident. So it was an accident.
It was a map bump.
We did not put a cheap knob gag in our family show.
Spice Girl reunion tour! Insider information. Myself, Bryony Corrigan, Nancy Zammit and Laura Kerman all actually attended the Spice Girl reunion tour. We knew we had tickets at this point, which is why we fought very hard for the Spice Girls to be part of the headlines.
One of my favourite things to watch being filmed What's the cauldron scene? Because it's just so silly. But also, the cleaner here who comes in and says, what the hell are you doing? Is Martin Dennis, our director, doing a bit of a Hitchcock there.
Get out! We're in the middle of filming.
You can see Hearn just laughing through that. But Martin, brilliant actor.
Very good actor.
We tried to get him in as Raymond Bean.
Yeah, we wanted Chris him Bean's to play dad. Yeah. Chris Bean's dad in the pilot, but he refused.
Because it was the first episode.
We are already devising a way for the cleaner to make a return in series two.
I'd give anything to see my Vera again.
So in this bit, when the painting pops open and I'm reading a book, I am reading Robert Groves' Anything You Can Act, I Can Act Louder.
Mm.
If you notice, it's very difficult to see, but that's what I'm reading.
But what was the actual book?
It was the book with the Dalai Lama and Desmond Tutu.
Very good. Was it a good read?
I actually did start reading it because I was behind there for quite a long time, and the lighting guys created a little sort of lighting setup for me so that I could read while I had to sit there for a while.
Very good. This is the famous gun routine from Henry Lewis, where we sort of try to recreate the long laugh sequence with a sort of complex musket loading. But the gun actually falls apart, and it wasn't meant to, because he dropped the rod in accidentally during rehearsal.
So when he breaks it in half and he's like screaming, that's all real.
That's all Henry Lewis not knowing what to do.
We have to leave now. The whole house is screaming it.
Dennis, get in.
I think the get out, get in sequence also just, Dennis usually has in all the episodes quite a different narrative than the whole of the rest of the team. He's usually trying to do something, usually one task that's incredibly simple. And I think that this one is the simplest and probably has the biggest arc and the biggest journey, which I think is why it's such a funny bit. And it was so much fun to do. Me and Shields were just so close to each other, just shouting, get out, get in, oh, sorry. It was so much fun to do.
Daddy!
Expect more boys.
It was briefly expect more boobies, but we thought that that was too immature in the end. So we changed that because the show's very highbrow and... obviously, we were worried that if we went with expect more boobies, we would lose our reputation as people who create high art.
I'm afraid there is no way out of the lodge.
Oh, also credit must go to the set builders and artists and stuff, because they built an entire kitchen, which we only see in shots, because obviously in the Goes Right version, we're meant to go into the kitchen two or three times, but you never get to see it.
It doesn't get the screen time maybe it deserves, because it's been made so brilliantly, but that's sort of the evidence of the commitment that the team had to the show, where they knew that you have to imagine it. They were thinking it wouldn't go wrong.
Mm.
Oh, sorry. And so you, if you plan for it to go wrong, then it won't be funny anymore. So they make it properly so that we can ruin it.
Please don't hurt me, Mummy.
Your mummy has gone. Has gone. My mum is dead.
I like how they've licked you as the ghost.
I know, it's amazing.
Very effective, isn't it?
I think they must have added something on in post. I don't think it was glowing that well.
Some fancy stuff.
Mm.
Fancy post business.
Help me! Help me!
Aha! No need to panic. I'm here now. I'm here.
Yes, again, it must be said that Greg Tannehill is an absolute hero and does such a great job of just coming in at the end. Greg is the master of having a very small task, but doing it extremely well.
And...
I also really love this because the three of us are like, oh no, oh, oh Bri, oh Vanessa, you killed Annie. Oh no, that wasn't meant to happen.
Having to stab her.
And the ghost looks feels bad about it.